Okay, in this tutorial, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to configure the DRV8825 stepper driver. Now, this is the DRV8825 stepper driver. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect it to the X port for the stepper driver on the MKS Gen L board. So, hang on. Okay, this is the underside of the stepper driver board, and what we're looking for the pin is over here, and it's the EN pin. So we need to line this up with the MKS Gen L board for the X stepper driver port. In a moment, I'll show you where to find that. Okay, this is the X port on the MKS Gen L board. What we're looking for is the EN pin, and that is where EN is, and the pin is located right here. So in a second, I'll show you how to connect them together with the driver board. Okay, to connect them, make sure we have the EN pin correct, which is right here. So we're going to rotate it over, line it up, and apply a little bit of thumb pressure, and that's how you install it. In a second, I'll show you how to set up the board for testing and also loading the firmware. Okay, so we want to connect first the end stop, so we're going to use Xmin. So I'm going to connect it right here. This is on the ground for red, and black is going to be the signal. And then we're going to move the stepper motor in here, and we're going to connect to the port for the stepper on X. In a second, I'll show you how to connect the USB so we can program the firmware. Okay, to connect the USB, we're going to connect the big side to the motherboard and the small side to the USB port on the computer, and you'll hear a beep. And in a moment, we'll program the firmware. Okay, we're in the Marlin folder here. We're gonna open that up. We're gonna go to the Marlin subfolder. We're gonna hit M on the keyboard, scroll down to marlin.ino, and hit enter. We're going to select the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on default_access_steps_per_unit. And here is where we have the settings for the drivers. You have the X, the Y, the Z, and the E, and then E's if you want to add them for additional extruders. So normally, it's set for 16 microsteps, which would be 80 in this case, but because we're using a DRV8825, it's got 32 microsteps. So we're going to change this to 160, which is double the resolution. So the next thing we want to do is verify that we're connected. So we got to select port 4, and then we've got to select the actual board type. In this case, it would be the Arduino Mega because the architecture is exactly the same as the MKS Gen L. So we're all set there. So we're going to compile and upload. And in a moment, I'll actually show you how to test it in Pronterface after we connect the power. Okay, in a moment, we're going to test this in Pronterface, but first we have to plug it in. So before we plug it in, I want to emphasize that you can't touch this area once you have it energized with electricity. So in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how to test this. Okay, we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the device. We're going to press the G-code M 119. This will give us the status of the end stops, and as you can see, the Xmin is open. So the next thing that we want to do is press the home for the x-axis. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to press the end stop to stop it. So you'll see in a second. Okay, that homed the axis, so I'm going to advance by 10. Now I'm going to advance by 100. Now I'm going to go back by 100. So, if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.